We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and hosts of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk. We won't complain. Here to lift up the downcast and the brokenhearted. Changing lives with the truth, so let's get it started. We got the word, music, entertainment, life. You can catch us on the air every Sunday night with special guests, the news, and interesting stories. A platform for the kingdom, you can got the glory. Worldwide, and we got the
hey, this is Ro Williams. And do not adjust your cameras. Trisha Mann Grant is out on the road with Miss Independent. And to my illustrious left is none other, our resident host, guest host with the most.
I'm Rory Darvell. Yes.
Who just flew into the studio, literally. Flew. You know, he has his watch set out. You know what? Actually, you're supposed to go back behind that way. That was our fashion camera woman, Sandra.
We just got TV bombed.
We just got you stream bombed. What's up with that? You know, we couldn't have gotten bombed by a more fashionable, more talented, more dedicated, more awesome woman of God and artiste. You know what? Let's plug her right now. What is her business? Wait, your camera's not. I mean, we're going to you put everybody's mic on right now. Go ahead.
All right. That's Sandra Presley. She's a graphic designer. Oh. And I say she's an angel sent by God, especially for kids in the spotlight. She make us look real good.
Yes. And that is actually the voice of one of our guests in studio tonight, Mrs. Taji Charity, who heads up Kids in the Spotlight. When we come back from commercial, we'll be sitting down with both her and the illustrious Brent Jones, who we have the honor of having in the house. Again,
I heard a lot about
and
him.
I know you guys know who he is, Grammy Award and multi stellar nominated, award nominated recording artist, producer, musician, and choir master. And we're gonna hear more about that because if you're in the East Coast, the West Coast region of California, I think is something he's got going down with KJLH and choir. So if y'all some singers or you know some singers out here on the West Coast, or if you got the budget to fly them out here, you might wanna, you know, tweet, face, Instagram, and send out the word to tune into this show because we'll be hearing more about that, as well as our event that we're collaborating together for a wonderful cause on this Wednesday. So that's our call to action. And
That was good. That was good.
Yeah, I like that. Say, let me give you some. That little, what do you call it? You stream bombed. That was tight.
Yes,
well, we, you know,
sure
you weren't
her camera time.
You weren't here in studio last week. I know you followed the show, so I'm so glad. But Trisha was, and on that show, we actually had our pastors from the Covenant. I think I have a picture of them up there for you guys to check out. And you know, it was an honor. Our Pastor Sanchez and his lovely wife, and they were here, and you know, of course, they're all married, and Trisha's married, so it was a lot of talk about marriages and what you need to do, and he was going on, you know, making all the married wannabe ladies jealous about how his wife don't shop for her underwear. He goes to Victoria's Secret. I'm like, Dad, you living like that? I want one of those. Where I get a model that says I don't have to do those things? So, you know, but it was a very encouraging an encouraging show. Wasn't just about just married and relationships in general, and just you know, an honest heart from the pastor. You know, he kept it real, Rory, because he was saying that it was his birthday and he had gotten some birthday money, and he had put a call to action to sow a seed, and then the Lord spoke to him about sowing that money that he had set aside for a bid that he had gotten on eBay for this particular watch, because he had already committed to buy it. He just hadn't sent the money. And so he was like, what? You want me to do what? And he was like, he was like, look, these dumb sheep, they don't do half the stuff, and you ain't never struck any of them dead. Why I got it? You know, and I told him, I really appreciated hearing a pastor just be honest about really not wanting to sow a seed, because he really, it was like my birthday. I already done bid it on the watch, and now you want me to give that money? And, you know, and you have to, I don't want to give it away. Tune into the show. But, you know, they're a wonderful pastor. If you're ever in the California area, or just go to thecovenantchurch.org and check them out. They're an amazing couple, and like I said, I love ministries where the leadership, they keep it real, and they're not just trying to fluff you up. They really want to empower you with some tools that will strengthen you, but also equip you to live this life and to run this race, like just like a coach should be doing in the gym, if you have a coach trainer, so to speak.
I don't.
You don't. But oh, you're your own trainer though, right? How are you doing with that?
I did 4 miles this morning.
Oh yeah,
running.
Oh well, praise the Lord.
And then my allergies kicked in, and I've been sneezing ever
You didn't
since.
Prepare? Well, again, we just want to, we're going to probably toss the commercial shortly, but if you would not mind just showing the images of our event flyer that's coming up this Wednesday.
I'm excited.
Featuring the awesome Brent Jones.
Brent Jones.
And I'm sure he'll be playing some old favorites and wannabes and letting you hear some of that, but also from his newly released album that's Burn It Up, the Billboard charts, Joy Coming. And
All right.
Yeah, and I think we on that note, we have also marked November 1st, which is the Kids in the Spotlight. That is going to be in Beverly Hills. Actually, both events are in Beverly Hills. We're at the House of Music and Entertainment in Beverly Hills, and the information is on the flyer, or you can give us a shout out at gospelrhythms.com, as well as kidsinthespotlight.org for the event on November 1st. Actually, you can go to both sites to get information probably about both events. Either way, we hope to see you there. And if you're not, guess what? It's going to be streamed live. Hit us up at the word jams at gospelrhythms.com if you'd like more information. We have our call-in studio number. What is it that you can call in if you have any questions?
Well, thank you for allowing me to do that. First of all, it's 323-473-3100.
Yes. And Sandra will be U-string bombing us on those. No, I'm just kidding.
Okay, on that note, we're going to party to the commercial. And when we come back, we're going to sit down. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. Pump it up, DJ, pump it up. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah.
She is thankful for her.
You know who this is, right? Brent Jones, baby. Recognize. Whoa, tell them all, Jack.
Tell them all, Jack. Like.
Tasty, refreshing, sweet, and tart. Happiness in a bottle. Visit Hubert's Lemonade at hubertslemonade.com. Once again, that's hubertslemonade.com. Happiness in a bottle. Xavier Tees and Tots, groundbreaking fashion, forward street smart designs. Tees and Tots for men, women, and boys. Visit XavierUSA.com. Once again, that's XavierUSA.com.
When I play your
Young Connection, your one-stop connection for all your graphic design and commercial printing needs. Young Connection is a full-service printing and media design company dedicated to providing the highest level of customer service and satisfaction. Young Connection provides swift response and rapid turnaround services for banners, brochures, business cards, flyers, logo design, posters, and much, much more, all at an affordable price. Young Connection, the official printing company of LA Talk Live. Give them a call at 310-491-3336. That's 310-491-3336. Or visit their website at www.youngconnection.com. That's www.youngconnection.com. Young Connection Printing and Media Services, proud sponsors of LA Talk Live, where it's more than just talk.
We're ready to come back after this right here. Just have your music ready, please.
Hi, I'm Ro Williams, and I would like to invite you to join GospelRhythms.com live every Sunday at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for our new show, Gospel Rhythms Talk Live. Join us as we celebrate, promote, and elevate Christians and Christians in entertainment. So don't forget to tune in to Gospel Rhythms Talk Live exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio under R&B or watch us on Ustream.tv. Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is Gospel Rhythms on LA Talk Live, where we don't just talk about it, we are about it.
Like Marvin Gaye, can't you see what's going on? Through it all, gospel rhythm still going strong. Trusting God when it's good or when it's going wrong. Encourage other believers to keep holding on.
Hey.
Catching the vision and we making it plain.
What's up? Welcome back. This is GospelRhythms.com, Talk Live Radio on LATalkLive.com. I'm Ro Williams, and sitting in for Trisha Mann Grant is
Rory Darbell.
He's kind of mesmerized by all the cues going on,
yeah,
you know. Like it's his first time in the
all
studio.
The technical things going
I'm
down.
Like, yeah, there is. Man, welcome back. Welcome back. This is our entertainment edition. We have a lot going on.
Woo,
and
yes.
If you hadn't gotten the call to action, tweet, Instagram, Facebook call, you know, knock on your neighbor's door, bring folks to the party, heaven's party. Woo, that's right. That's whose party it is. Mm-hmm. Jesus' party, as my DM would say. Yeah. And we are in the house with our guests. Thank you so much. We have the lovely Taji Charity, founder, creator, leader of the Kids in the Spotlight organization. And for those of you who haven't been connected with what we've been sharing over the past a lot of weeks, kids, I'll just give you a little brief synopsis because she has been on our show before and we've gone into detail, but it's a 503c3 nonprofit organization that trains underserved youth to create, write, cast, and star in their own film shorts. And they have an event coming up on November 1st, and she's here to talk about that. But the reason why she's also here, along with the multi-award nominated recording artist,
Stellar
fabulous, woo, Brent Jones is here.
Brent Jones.
Who also has his vision that God has given him out on out in the market called Joy Coming. He is here. Yay!
What's up?
All right. Back in the house. Just was here. Your album just dropped on the 24th of August.
Heaven's Party on Earth.
I mean, that wasn't the drop date. That was the release party date.
That was the release party date. The drop was August the 12th.
Yeah. So I remember the 24th because, you know, that's a national holiday. That's my birthday.
Well, of course.
And
doing your thing too on that night.
And let me tell you, if you guys are like, oh, who wants to go to a party with a bunch of Christians? I'm like, he is definitely elevating the bar and showing how, you know, you can have fun in Christ and it not be, wake me when it's over type of party.
Right.
Woo!
Because you had fun, right?
You were having fun.
Yeah, we had fun.
We had a bomb DJ who is going to be at the event we have Wednesday and holding it down, spinning on the ones and twos.
Yeah.
And
sounds like it was fun. I wasn't there.
It was fabulous and it was fun. You know, we had DJ Mosky and you know, we partied, and it wasn't just Sunday morning music. We had, you know, old school R&B, 90s and 80s, and we was turned up, and it was, everybody felt good. My mama was there, y'all. You know, and she even hit the dance floor with her baby. So, you know, it was really cool. It was really cool.
I think that sounds, you know, like when we grow up and God, and see how God has blessed us with so many things, it's like, you know, we have to give back. We can't just, you know, have a party. And I think when people were invited to the party, I get it. And when people were invited to the party,
the skills,
I think, and they didn't come, what did the Lord do? He opened up the doors and went out and got the throwaway people. Well, we are called to go and find those and love on them and show them that they are just as worthy to be invited to the party, no matter where life has taken them.
Right.
And thereby, we have this wonderful vision that takes these kids that for all intents and purposes can be considered throwaway kids, because their parents are on drugs or they are unwanted because they have issues of behavioral issues. And I mean, I think the work that God has both of you doing, and the work for the kingdom, is awesome, because you don't just, the kids that your organization reaches out to aren't just strictly, you don't discriminate. You love on every kid.
Absolutely. We remind them all the time that they were created to do great things, and that they were created by a great creator to do those great things. So your circumstance and your situation does not have to dictate the outcome in life, and your choices that you make in life. So,
okay, we're going to take a, can you just lower his mic a little bit? Because it's covering your face. So just like, yeah.
They want the people to see you.
Yeah.
See all the handsomeness that is Brent Jones.
The handsomeness that is Brent Jones. That is him. Thank you. You know, we just have to take a pause and just thank Van Eyre, because he is my studio husband, as he like to call himself. Thank you very much.
Fight like cat and dog.
Yeah, I'm just training him up in the way that he should be a husband. His life has been photobombed by me. So on that note, yes, loving on these kids.
Absolutely.
And giving them an opportunity to
tell their stories their way.
Yeah. And to learn that life has other avenues.
Absolutely.
You know, because you know, in filmmaking, it's not just about the story. It's not just about the shooting of the story, but there's
the process.
Makeup. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the process. There's wardrobe and even music and scoring music. Mm-hmm. And you, absolutely, as a musical director, I mean, I don't know if when you do plays, is that considered scoring?
It is.
Yeah, I do.
Okay. There's a whole just day of just scoring, mm-hmm, and where I sit with my director and we go through scene by scene. I have a script in front of me, scene by scene, and we score the whole 100 and some pages of dialogue. Yeah, so it's very important, and it's very effective when you go see a production like that.
So I love
my favorite was Something to Sing About.
Woo! But you know, I love the fact that, you know, here, you know, God has given us gifts and we give back, and how just by with your organization being a vehicle that can, you know, allow a kid to maybe consider scoring, you know, getting to music to the point where they want to do that very thing, mm-hmm, whereas had they not been exposed to that possibility.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
You know, I remember I was in a program, you know, because the way I grew up, I didn't know anything about going to the opera or going to the theater, because that was not on my mother's educational path. Like, she wasn't exposed to that as a child. I was exposed to the things that they were exposed to.
Right.
And it really showed me life beyond my economic borders, my profession, just my own abilities. Like, and I love the fact that your program encourages kids to dream with their eyes open.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
And so, with that being said, we have this event on Wednesday, and the event is really to culminate, to celebrate fundraising efforts. And during the process of even working out a vision, I just want you guys to share, and Rory, you can chime in too, because you have a dream and you have a vision. I always see you all over the place with the mic, you know, pursuing the stuff that you do. You know, how do you stay encouraged in the process, especially if you've been doing toiling a long time, you know what I mean? And not abandon it, you know, and still give it 100%, even on the millionth day that you look back and it still seems like you have been in the same place forever, trying to get to where you see, you know, God has told you you're going to be, the promised land.
Mm-hmm.
How do you
I like to speak on it. This record, I started 4 years ago, 2010, And July 2010, we did all of the basic choir vocals on the East Coast. And life happened. We were in the middle of that thing called a recession. Mm-hmm. And everyone was trying to figure out how to live this new life. And so I kind of had to put things on hold. And transitioning back to the West Coast and all of that, now launching a daughter into college and having that bill on my hands and trying to produce a record, college tuition, produce a record, college tuition. And I'm like, and then recession, produce a record, college tuition.
And you have a wife.
And I have a wife and her business.
There it is. That's
and
big
everybody's,
part of it.
Everybody in my house is entrepreneur and creative. And I'm thinking, ooh, this creative stuff costs a lot of money, but the recession and all the things that I was that I depended on before the recession, you know, had lots of property, had invested lots of money in the property, and those who were in that game like I was, we lost a lot of money, and it was very scary, and it was I had never been through anything like that. I remember my parents telling me, oh son, you know, this happened back in 19 something something, and you know, da da da, and I'm thinking, okay, well, I don't know anything about that. I'm thinking that everything I buy called real estate is going to appreciate in value, and but now y'all telling me it's not, and y'all, it was a scary place. And so I understand what it means to give up and to feel like, you know, throwing in the towel and all that. I threw in the towel. Now, I was in front of church people all along while I threw in the towel, acting like I did not throw in the towel. Mm-hmm. and going through the motions, and so everybody thinking, you know, Brent is Superman. No, I wasn't Superman. I had thrown in the towel, but I had learned the fake game of let me just be put my church face on and nobody will know what I'm going through.
The troubles,
but
you see.
Oh my goodness, inside I was dead. Mm-hmm. Literally I was dead, you know. And but when you here's the turnaround, when you know you're called to something,
right?
Okay, when you know you're called to something, you have to get beyond and over your emotions.
Live above.
Ooh, that was the word right there for somebody. I just spoke to myself. That's why I felt it. When you know you're called to something, okay, you're going to have some good days. You're going to have some bad days. You're going to have some rich days. You're going to have some poor days. But when you know beyond the shadow of doubt that God has called you to something, you walk in your promise. You walk in it. You walk in it.
I gotta write that down. Walk
sometime,
in your promise.
Sometimes you have to close your eyes because what you see will get on your nerves and challenge you and immobilize you. So keep walking. Close your eyes because faith is those things you can't even see anyway. So closing your eyes, it's okay. Okay, you know, so 4 years later, 3,000 miles later, daughter third year college, ain't missed a payment yet, dealt with the real estate situation, album is out, started with a distribution situation, had to change distribution situations, again, setback again, but I'm here today. I'm looking at, when I go to these stores and I see my CD on the shelf with Brent Jones tag on it again, I hear the Lord say, just keep on walking in your promise.
Wow, you're about to make me cry.
Just keep on walking in your promise, yes. You know, because if I would have given up on this, and I'm a songwriter, I can come up with songs just in my sleep. I can come up with songs. But God said, no, these are the songs that need the body of Christ needs these songs right now. And let me just say this. I had a very top executive tell me that the song called He Rose, you should have never put that on the record. Oh, it's antiquated. It sounds too old school. Don't nobody sing like that no more. Da, 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 da. Ladies and gentlemen, that song is moving so fastly up the Billboard charts. It's not even funny. It is number one here in Los Angeles.
Wow.
And if I would have just listened to what someone else's vision might have been and not walk in my promise, I would have missed out. I would have missed out on this song, He Rose. You know, I did He Rose 12 years ago with the church choir I was working with. And, you know, here we are 12 years later, He Rose. And it's the biggest thing that, not the biggest thing in my career musically, but it's doing so well. And I was like, wow, He Rose. It's such a simple kind of thing. And so I thank God that he gave me the strength to get over me.
Mm. Ooh, I like good. I've got. He gave me the strength. I feel like I'm in church.
To good. Get over me, because me, Lord have mercy, I'm stubborn. I'm spoiled. I'm opinionated. I got issues, y'all. I'm sorry. I'm saved. I'm anointed, but I got all them kind of issues. I had to get over me and say, me. What did God say?
and get out the way.
I know you're smart, you're intelligent, but I'm able to do greater above what you can think or imagine. That's God, y'all. Mm. And so because he's God and I'm not, I defer. I say, oh, okay. So I thank God for joy coming, okay? So joy happens when you connect with that thing that you know God has called you to do. That's when joy happens. See, we've got addicted to happiness. We've got addicted to just,
something
did that. Something happened. And we've got addicted to that. So we keep on making things happen all the time. So we begin to get busy. The devil is busy. Mm-hmm. We get to get busy, and we're wearing ourselves out doing something that God has not really called us to do. Connect with your purpose, and that's when the joy comes. Thank you, Jesus, for Pharrell and the song Happy God Love You. I love the song. I do it in church, and my choir does it, da-da-da-da. But we as saints know that happiness is the first level. That's just a level. That's just a level. But joy is that level that God wants us to be in, because in his presence, there's fullness of
joy.
Come on, Zion.
Wait. We need to clap. Come on, you know? Brother. Man, you just took us to church and back. Right. I mean, how do you, man? I mean, I was taking notes, you know, because even Pastor Sanchez, he said, problems have expiration dates. Mm-hmm. God's mm-hmm. promises do not.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know, and I'm gonna tell you, I was in a car accident yesterday.
Mm.
My car got hit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can't even drive it.
Lord have mercy.
3 days before our event.
Mm.
Mm-hmm. I'm carless.
Mm-hmm.
I just had an accident, and all it was a hit and run.
Mm-hmm.
He hit me and he ran. Mm-hmm. He hit me and he ran. And you were there, Taji, because
yes.
we were supporting another artist, Arthur.
Right.
T-Fay.
Mm-hmm.
Morning Manna.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. And so I called her. I was all in a panic because we both were in shock, and we were in a really not so good part of town.
Mm-hmm.
And the person who hit us, he looked like he was straight out of Compton, the movie.
Uh-huh.
And
just out of Compton,
but the movie.
Because
you know, and you know, you have to realize, although you go out into the world with the Spirit of the Lord, you never know what the circumstances are going to be.
Right.
Needless to say, he left. You mm-hmm. know, after it wasn't like it was stranger information, wasn't trying to be there. I don't know. But at the end of the day, I think you were there. I had to say, you know what? I don't know why this happened at the time this happened, but I know that God must have allowed it to help build up my faith muscles
mm-hmm.
because it's just a car.
Mm-hmm.
God provided me the car. Whatever happened didn't take him by surprise because
mm-hmm.
he can see around corners. But I have to not be so caught up in, you know, oh, I just got my car detailed. I just got to fix, you know, all those things. Like, you have to get over mm-hmm. yourself and mm-hmm. get out the way,
mm-hmm.
you know. Mm-hmm. And how, you know, what the heck, you know. Mm-hmm. And I just had to just pray. I think the last thing I said, I am not going to leave here. And I told the girl, because it was a messy situation. The girl I hit was pregnant, had a kid in the car,
mm-hmm.
and her license was suspended.
Mm.
And so when we were sitting here talking, and you know, when you're talking about not just joy in your purpose, but living out joy in day-to-day experiences
mm-hmm.
can be a challenge
mm-hmm.
because life happens in pursuit of your purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Like you said, mm-hmm. you know, the market mm-hmm. crash and mm-hmm. all those stuff. And mm-hmm. you hear you had this album in process, mm-hmm. Work in process.
Mm-hmm.
And I look at the show almost as therapy for myself
mm-hmm.
because you guys have the anointing to do worldwide things for the Lord,
mm-hmm.
you know,
mm-hmm.
and I know some of the challenges and obstacles because we're connected and working together, and I know the music business has so evolved
mm-hmm.
that it's a different beast than it was back in the day, and the way you have to, you know, seek the Lord on getting marketed and getting out there is totally different. And even with your organization, because there's 50 million zillion kids organizations. So how do you allow God to elevate and bring your visions to all men because mm-hmm. your purpose to lift mm-hmm. the light of Christ? And
mm-hmm.
so I just wanted to say that, you like you said, happiness depended on something happening, but the joy that I had right at that moment, I took inventory of the things that were a blessing. Nobody was hurt.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was just the car.
Mm-hmm.
We walked away. Mm-hmm. They towed our cars. I didn't have rental, nor did rental coverage, and nor did the other lady have rental coverage.
Mm-hmm.
But the guy who towed our car said he will make sure that we have a rental to use until our car is repaired. And so I just have to, let's get a Lord, a hand clap. So that couldn't have happened. You know, it's like God, he makes a provision. I guess that's right. Ram in the bush, right?
Mm-hmm, right. Mm-hmm.
Where he guides, he will provide. And absolutely. So thank you for encouraging amen. Us. I know you encouraged right. me. Mm-hmm. And but I know God is doing awesome things. So stay right. encouraged for sure. And absolutely. And with you and these kids, because I asked her on the way in the car. I said, can't you just, are you like me? And like, oh, I just can't wait till the event is over because you have so much you're trying to manage. It just can, it's just a big responsibility. And you, would you say?
It's a big responsibility. Absolutely. Absolutely. But at the end of the day, my husband reminds me all the time. He said, it's God's vision. If it's God's vision, God is going to do it. He's going to deliver the promises. He's going to deliver the goods. He's a faithful God. And the man of God just said it all. I mean, there's nothing else to say on top of that other than we just have to trust God.
Yeah.
And allow him to do it his way. I mean, we're just vessels. We're only vessels.
Right.
And he aligns who he aligns to work with us, and who he separates. Mm-hmm. You know, it is all his. And I'm constantly being reminded of that because my husband sees me all the time. I got to do this. This is not going to happen. He's like, is it God's vision or is it your vision? I'm like, well, it's God's vision. Well, let God do it. And I'm like, well, amen, brother. You know, so it's just a matter of submitting. And you said, how do you allow God to do it? It's just that. You allow God to do it. And it's a matter of trust and faith and walking in it. And sometimes that's easier said than done because yeah. we get busy. But sometimes it's just a matter of surrendering. Okay, God, I trust you. I trust you. It's yours. And we go from there.
Sometimes I think, and Rory, you could chime in, faith without works is dead.
Absolutely.
And what I think God has showed me when I went in some my quiet time with him, that sometimes the work isn't a actual task that you're doing. Mm. The work that you're doing is I was reading I think it's Haggai 2, and it was talking about the temple and what it was in its former life versus what it was going to look after God finished putting his hands back on it. And I love how he's saying, I am the God of the silver and the gold. Mm-hmm. Keep the faith, believe in me, but do the work. And I was reading it, and God also revealed to me that having faith is also work, because you have to work out to be at a point where you're believing that God is really going to do what he says he's going to do. But absolutely. I think in my temporal state, I often feel like, well, God, if I'm not doing anything, I feel like my faith, that means I don't have faith and I don't believe, and I'm just waiting for yeah. you to do something. Yeah. Like, how do you know when you're supposed to not do anything and just wait versus when you need to be busy about, like, how can you differentiate? Like, how would you counsel somebody, or at least from your experience, to be able to know, you know, that you should be doing something versus you should be just being quiet before God?
Well, God, first of all, said that my sheep know my voice. And God will tell you when it's time to move and when it's time to be still. And waiting sometimes is work, because especially when you're a busybody and you see all the things that you need to do and you could be doing. And then God say, just wait and allow me to do it. I remember in 2009 when I was going through in my corporate job, and I knew the day that they were getting ready to lay off. It was the second round of layoffs, and I knew that I was going to be laid off. And I went in the bathroom and I called my husband. I said, I think I'm going to be laid off today. He's like, okay, fine. And I was just like, what? So I went back and I was like, okay, what? And God just reminded me. He said, I'm in control today, yesterday, and every day. And I had such a peace. And within 15 minutes, HR came and knocked on the door to my office, and I was cool. And then from that point on, in 2009, is when God gave me the vision for Kids in the Spotlight. So when he opened the door, you will know when God says to move and when God says to be still. But you that comes in having that personal relationship and right. spending time in his word.
Wow.
For me, I'm very God wannabe. And I say that because I struggle with anxiety when I'm not busy. I feel like I have to be doing something, or I'm being lazy, mm-hmm. or I'm being waiting yeah, complacent. I'm just waiting on God. You know, the church, you know, wait on the Lord and be of good courage. So I'm thinking, does that mean I just go to sleep? I mean, what does that mean?
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So I come from a background of both of my parents were workaholics, and whatever they wanted, I didn't see them walk in faith a lot. That's not my background. I saw them do the work. You know, it was a, you know, if they wanted to drive that, they, you know, they, okay, so this is what it's going to take, and they did that. And so that's kind of what I saw. And so me growing up, you know, baby, we're just going to wait on the Lord and be of good courage, faith without works, you know, have faith. And, you know, I didn't grow up with that kind of language, you know. Mm-hmm. So growing up in God things, that was a muscle that I had to really work out. Juanita Bynum sang a great song that just still blesses me to this day. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting on you, Lord. And I'm thinking, ooh, I feel like when I sing that I'm lying, because I do mind waiting.
No, that's real time.
You know what I'm saying? I do mind waiting, Lord. You know, I mean, the song is so annoying. Don't mind waiting. Don't mind wait. Don't mind. And I'm thinking,
that's a lot
but
of songs.
But I do. Well, I do mind waiting. You know, I think to answer your question, Ro, we don't want to feel uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
When it gets uncomfortable, and I have to speak from a man place, because our responsibility is to take care of the house and to be the rule of the house, and you know, this is what I saw, the run the house, you know, and you are the lead, you're the head, you're all those things. And so if I get uncomfortable, especially financially, I'm a mess. If I could just be real, real good, mm-hmm. bucket honest with y'all, I'm a mess.
I think we all are.
Now, I'm much better than what I used to be, mm-hmm. because I've seen the anxiety attacks in me, my stomach getting all crazy, can't keep food down, and all that kind of stuff. You know what I've learned through the process of learning? I don't have to be anxious for anything. Mm-hmm. I've learned that peace is my strongest weapon.
Mm. Ooh, I got another good one.
That's good.
Peace. And we need to redefine what success is.
Amen to that.
We live in Southern California, Hollywood. So we see successful things, material things all the time. On every street, on every hill, on every, whether it be Beverly or Hollywood or whatever hill, we see successful things. But this is what we also see, and let's just keep it very real. We also see what the world says a success.
Yes.
We see a lot of that failing. Mm-hmm. When you have multi-millionaires taking their life, when you see successful, financially successful people having obvious problems in their relationships, in their marriages, or what have you. You know, it makes you take a step back and go, now what is being rich really?
Mm, yeah. Right.
Yeah.
What is? I learned that peace, oh my God, is my greatest asset, because when I'm sitting on top of the world financially, if I don't have any peace, and I've been there 4 and 5 gigs a week, sleeping in the airports, you don't even know where you're coming or going, what time zone it's in, and you know, your bank is full of money, all your real estate is working out, and da 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 da. But when I tell you, all of my vices were awakened, I'm being real honest with you, I don't know why the Holy Ghost is making me do this, all of my weaknesses were very strong. Because all of the busyness and the stuff almost was pulling me away from who
entices
I really was,
you and
who I was,
you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, who I was, you know. And I didn't have no peace. Didn't have no peace. I had a teenage daughter growing up, and she was growing up without me. And I'm thinking, this is not cool. And I knew it wasn't cool.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But and I said, I need that connection with my baby girl, and I don't know how to do, because I'm gone from home 5 and 6 days a week. So how do I do all of this? And you know, thank you, Jesus, for teaching me that peace is my greatest asset, beyond real estate, cars, and land, all that stuff. Peace. When I'm able to walk out on the beach and to pray and to lift my hand and say, God, if you can take care of these waves hitting up against these rocks mm-hmm. on every coast in this thing called the right. planet, surely you can take care of my little old problems that I think I have.
Absolutely.
Just like you walked out of there with peace.
Absolutely.
You know, the two words that come to mind is being content but not mm-hmm. complacent. And one of the things mm-hmm. I love about you, Rory, is that Rory is a singer too. Mm. And but he is content in the marketplace mm-hmm. that he has a niche in.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And you could tell us here a little bit about that because it's not like he is, I don't know if you're trying to put out an album. I just know that you're an entertainer and you enjoy singing and it's karaoke. Mm-hmm. In competitions, but mm-hmm. he enjoys it. Mm-hmm. It's like a gift God's given him out on the side. It's not like it's his main thing, but mm-hmm. talk, baby.
Well, for me, and wonderful things what you were saying about God's promise and purpose and things. For me, I think of and the thing about what is success, and I'm not necessarily trying to put out a CD or yeah. anything of that. My purpose. And that's all I can go on is because you have to search yourself sometimes when you don't know. You know, I remember when I graduated from high school, and it was kind of funny. I really did not know what I wanted to do mm-hmm. for a living. Mm-hmm. And at the time, I thought I wanted to be a social worker, but I wanted to do things that help people. So at the time, I wanted to be a social worker, and I was discouraged from that by the counselor. They said, well, there's no money in that. And obviously, you know, at 17, 18, you're thinking about how am I going to make some money.
Right.
And still do something worthy, but, you know, you want to get paid. Mm-hmm. And but I was told that wasn't it. Social work wasn't moneymaker. Didn't get paid. And then it was something, I think a cameraman. I wanted to be a cameraman. I was fascinated by camera work, television. And I used to go to the Laker games. And at the forum, and I used to sit by the cameraman. I would sneak and watch them work. And then I was wondering, how do you get into that? And it was like, we got to know somebody. Well, I don't know anybody. So I'm
crossed out off the list.
Right. So I knew I just wanted to graduate, and I was sick of school. I was ready to be done. I'd been going for 12 years, you know, then a lifetime of school. I'm done. So my dad was like, where are you going to go to school? I said, well, I'm take some time to find myself. And basically, you know, parents back then, well, you ain't going to school. You're going to find yourself living on the street. I didn't have the grades to go to UCLA, USC. So West LA Junior College, here I come just to say I'm in school. But I didn't do anything there. I learned how to play dominoes there and just hanging out and took a couple of but I took a broadcasting class, which was television entertainment based. And then I said, well, what have I done all my life? What have I always just done? You know, you just kind of go back. I've always liked to sing, but more so entertain. I just like entertaining people, mm-hmm. be it making you laugh or, you know, singing or whatever. And so that's, and then years on, of course you're thinking, you know, I want to be Michael Jackson, you know, at the time, or I want to be this big star because I want to entertain around the world and so on and so forth. And then I look at it and I say, but you know what? I'm not Michael Jackson. I'm not, you know, Beyonce or whatever, not entertain, but I do entertain a lot of people. Mm-hmm. I am doing my purpose, and I'm comfortable. Mm-hmm. Now I do want to do it for a living. You know, getting up to go to, because there's your purpose and there's your job. Mm-hmm. And so I've never been comfortable. I've had more jobs than a Jamaican on a living color. I've had a lot of jobs.
Keep it real.
I mean, it's just true. Because the way my spirit is, the way I am, I don't like being in the same spot every day. Mm-hmm. So eventually I would either get fired or I do something to sabotage my own self. Because mm-hmm. my spirit would say, this is not it. This is not what you're supposed to be doing. So I'm just, you know, where I work now, only reason I've been at that job for 14 years is because it's outdoors. I'm not in the same space every day. Mm-hmm. If I had to say come in here every day, you'd fire me. Because it's just the confines. Mm-hmm. But as far as just, I love to entertain. It's comfortable. I mean, it's just, it feels me. Mm-hmm.
It but you found a niche where you can still walk in a dream, even if it hasn't necessarily graduated to a level that you aspire to or even think it can be, you know. I admire that, because some people aren't content with that. They're like, you know, they're tired of doing Vegas because they want to be on tour with a big artist, but they don't see the joy in the fact that they're there doing it at all, you know.
And I'd love to do Vegas. I could go from hotel to hotel, because, you know, I could get on that circuit for years, because I don't have to do $1 million. I love to make $1 million. Don't get me lying. Right. I'm just saying. But if I made the same money entertaining for a living that I make doing what I do for a living, mm-hmm. at the end of the day, mm-hmm. I'd be good, mm-hmm. because I'm entertaining, mm-hmm. and I'm able to sustain a lifestyle. I'm able to live. I'm able to do my traveling, what I like to do. You know, I do my cruises and that kind mm-hmm. of thing. Mm-hmm. So if I'm able to maintain and keep my health insurance and so on and so forth, get on mm-hmm. Obamacare at that point, because, you know, after that, because you know, water power, they get the health care. But
something's wrong with the sound.
And
oh, sorry. Okay.
And it's a short.
Yeah.
I think there.
Yeah.
So but yeah. And when you're speaking on the purpose and about the peace, mm-hmm. when you talk about being busy, what was interesting, people will say that they got all these problems, you know, and it seems like the world is just collapsing. And one thing I've learned to do, what I'm thankful for, that I'm able to do, is I have this thing where you say, stop the world so I can get off. And I tell people the best thing to do for you, and the best way to hear God, is to be quiet. Mm-hmm. So, because you're trying to put out all these fires, you say with your daughter and the wife and the, mm-hmm. you know, the family, you got trying to put all these fires. You can't do it mm-hmm. in chaos. You can't do it. You have to just step back and be quiet mm-hmm. and listen.
Shut it down.
And then listen, and then everything, because then it's just this natural way of things being prioritized. What's really what I need to do first, and everything will come together. And then, like you were saying about being laid off, the whole thing, you'll be able to handle it, because most people panic because they don't know what to do, mm-hmm. and that's why they don't know what's going to happen on the other side. Mm-hmm. If this happens, oh God, so what's the worst case scenario if you lose your job? What's the worst? Are you going to die? And see, that's to me. If I'm not going to die, then that means I am able. Mm-hmm. God has given me the ability
mm-hmm.
to go to whatever the next step. Mm-hmm. Paint a canvas. When they say there's nothing out there, exactly, paint it. Mm-hmm. It's like a painter.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
This wall is blank. Put mm-hmm. something on it. Mm-hmm. It's up to you.
You know, my brother, when he had told me one time, because I had a stack of bills and it had gotten so bad, when bills would come to the house, Audrey and I, my prayer partner, you ever have a prayer partner and both of y'all like crackheads? It's like, why are we even prayer partners? Because we ain't lifting nothing up but the devil. And I had a stack of bills I was afraid to open, and she had a stack. No, actually, it was you. Oh, my God. So I'll never forget the day Audrey's going to come by,
because
I needed her to hold my hand. And this is his brother right here. He was like, you Christians crack me up. What are they going to do? They throw you in jail? They don't have a debtor's jail.
They don't have a debtor's jail.
And what's the worst that happened? Just talk to him. And I was like, that is true. I don't have a debtor's jail anymore. But then the fact that it came from him, it just like,
the heathen.
I was like, how dare he? Yeah, I was like, you. I'm like, oh my goodness. And so I was like, by the time she came over, I had made all my faith calls, opened up those envelopes. And I think that process that we have to do in life with just the basic day-to-day maintenance things mm-hmm. is even turned up, as they say, that much more when God says, I got this big vision for you, a worldwide organization for kids, and this multi-platform music from the things you'll do with film, television, and the album. It's like, and then you like, okay, how is this supposed to all go down? This journey to the promised land.
I tell people, chaos is part of the process.
And you have to respect the process.
You have to respect that. But see, the thing is, especially when you're the head of something, and there is a big vision, or there is a big, God has a large plan for you. Well, it ain't supposed to be. Oh, no, I'm just. It's not supposed to be. It's just like nature and earth. There's going to be earthquakes. There's going to be tornadoes. That's what it is. But there's going to be days there where it's beautiful. You go out and you say, oh my God, there's not a cloud in the sky, and mm-hmm. nice little breeze and so on and so on. You know what I say? For me, life philosophy, life is a roller coaster. Mm-hmm. There's all kinds of roller coasters. And at the end of the day, you just want to ride the best one.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
You want to ride the best one. Because they're going to be there. Ah, right, it's right, not right. going to be like this. It's right. not. And it's not always going to be down. It's going to be this.
Right.
And it's going to be turn. You just want to ride the best one.
Right. I mean, the Bible says without faith, it is impossible to please God. And I think if God told us or showed us the entire vision, one, there would be no need for faith. And two, it would probably overwhelm us and kill us. We probably couldn't even handle.
I think the portion that he shows us is overwhelming.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
You know? And
so if he showed the whole vision, my God.
So speaking of visions, let's talk about where you guys are currently at with your current visions. Okay, it dropped on the 12th of August. The release party was the 24th. Where do you see God taking your vision of this Joy Coming project? And are you taking it one day at a time as an artist? And
God does not allow me to be comfortable. I just understand that now.
Used to being uncomfortable.
Right. See, being an artist for me now, at this point in the game, it's very comfortable for me. I know what to do. I know, a record comes out, you can promote it on radio, then you start doing dates and doing tours and da-da-da-da. God said, okay, next level now. And so he's calling my wife. My wife and I were ordained back in July of this year and ordained pastors. And he's calling me to that uncomfortable zone again as pastors. To call me a pastor is really weird because I have such... I have so many problems with the traditional church, and so to call me a pastor, I'm like, God, I don't know. You don't know. You might be not going. I don't know if I'm the right one. My wife, she's cool. She's more loving, if you will. I've been hurt and damaged and all those kind of things, and I'm not holding the victim card at all, but. For me to be a pastor at this point in my game, and I'm thinking, Lord, I'm very scared, but I have such a heart for people, especially that age group of 18 to 30. I had a group called the TP Mob here in this city for years, and that was our whole thing. Let's just do it out the box and weird, and let's just shake it up and not be normal. And for 18 years, that's what we did. The TP Mob, in where everybody had a group called something something Corral, something something Singers, something something Mass Choir. Here we come, Brent Jones and the TP Mob. What? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it was like, so here I am, years later. It's still in my heart to do things different. I'm glad. I love hip hop because what hip hop did for mainstream is that it went left. And I remember when it was talk. Oh, hip hop won't last. Mm-hmm. Hip hop is just a phase, and hip hop runs the music industry now. You know what I'm saying? So now it's time for me and my wife to start our ministry. I don't want a steeple and a cross and a little choir stand and a little podium. I do not want that. I don't know how our ministry / church is going to look, but I know he's called us to it. And so we're in the process now of kind of putting our vision on paper and, making it plain and giving it to God and say, what do you think about this? So when I tell y'all, this is very uncomfortable for me. I know I minister on a lot of different levels, but pastor, there's a stigma with that word,
And there is also an enormous responsibility as far as God is concerned.
Right.
You still get out the bed and put one leg in a pair of pants like the rest of us.
Right.
But the perception oftentimes is you're put so on a pedestal that you don't want to get to that place where, like you were back early years, you would show up and you'd show one way, but you'd be inside a different way, a different person. And wow. And
yes, I've been pastoring for years because I've been a minister of music. And, that's really pastoring. You got hundreds of people that come to you every week, and then you're teaching them and pouring them into them music and songs and words and what praise is and what worship is. And you're speaking the word to them and getting them to understand the word and what position they have in the spirit realm in music. So it was a level of pastoring already, but now to be called Pastor Brent, it's just very different for me. And again, it just makes me very uncomfortable. So my prayer, I need y'all to pray for me that Brent will walk in his uncomfortability. That's it.
You know what? Can you say that prayer? Because let's talk about that. Your wife, she is an entrepreneur, and she has her thing.
Yes.
So we're going to show you how layered God is. Like, he doesn't call you just do. If that was the only thing he was doing, it'd probably be not too bad. Not too much big of an uncomfortable. But then you have the album project vision, and you're still doing your other stuff. And then even this event, we both were taught. We were going. It was like God kind of pulled it together so easy for us.
Right.
You were like, she was like, to be honest, I was going to cancel. And to be honest, I was like, I was not going to trip on it because it was uncomfortable for me. Because you're like, God, is this really like how you are allowing all this stuff to come together? Mm-hmm. Oh my God. Right. And I'm sorry. And you, Miss, where do you see this vision with the kids? And then I want you to plug the thing you're doing with KGLH because that's another layer.
Okay,
before we go off air.
You know, it's just a day by day. I don't even know because God is constantly blowing my mind. Couple of weeks ago, I got a call from Department of Children and Family Services telling me that Deputy Supervisor Antonio, what's his name? God help me remember his name. But the Deputy Supervisor is Michael Antoniovich. Thank you, Jesus. Is honoring me. Along with basketball legend Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Mm. And I'm just like, what? You know, just, we've only been in existence for 5 years. We're just doing this. Thank you. we're doing this thing one day at a time, trusting God with little to no resources. But it's like, God, you own the heavens and the earth. You know, you are the supplier. So I just, it's one day at a time. It's like, God, wherever you take us, that's where we want to go. But if I had to set a vision and say what I'd like to see, I'd like to see the organization be nationwide to reach every foster care kid we can possibly get our hands on and to show them that there is hope and that they were created to do great things. But it's in God's hands. So
I love
wherever you take us.
Oh, and so if you're interested in knowing more about Kids in the Spotlight, can you put the flyer up there? The website is kidsinthespotlight.org or KITSinc.org, and you can learn about how you can sow some of your gifts and talents on any of the film projects or sow your money into the vision as well, because you know, money does make the program work as well as people, so they need both. So do as the Lord leads you, and or as your heart leads you. And with Brent Jones, can you his picture up there, the album is Joy Coming. And real quick, you have some things in the work with a radio station you're partnering with. You want to share with a little bit about that?
KGLH.
Never heard of them.
Owned by the musical icon Stevie Wonder. They have come to me and asked me to head up their choir, KGLH Radio Free Voices. And it's a performance choir, a show choir. And wow, what an honor. So already 2 weekends in, we've had auditions. We're over 75 singers already.
Are you looking for more?
We're looking for after this month events. I'm going to open back the auditions back up in November. Our goal is to get to 150 singers. We're going to do a big debut concert in February for Black History. Nice. It's just it's a privilege and an honor to be asked to partner with a musical icon like Stevie Wonder, and to be able to do music that touches people's hearts. It is not just a gospel choir. We do gospel, of course, but we do great Stevie Wonder songs. We do. I'm teaching them of Troop. Y'all remember Troop? '80s and '90s. Spread My Wings.
Yep.
We're doing a version of that. I've arranged a version of that, and it's so off the hook. So we're dancers, we're performers, and so. I'm just very, very honored to be a part of something like this. Stevie's excited, the station's excited, and the choir is off the hook already. When I tell you, everybody can sing, and it's just one of those feelings. And they've had, you know, some directors in the past, and so they say, Brent, we feel like it's you. We feel like it's you. And I'm thinking, wow, you know. And I've heard the announcements of the choir before, years past, and so to be here now. And again, I thank God for not giving up, you
Amen.
Know,
because yeah.
if I would have given up, I wouldn't be here now. And so and I know that there's a purpose for this choir other than just music. There's going to be a lot of ministry opportunity. And, you know, I welcome that. This Wednesday, can I plug
yes,
this Wednesday?
Yes, of course.
This Wednesday at the home restaurant, the House of Music and Entertainment in Beverly Hills. We're bringing gospel and positive music to a club/restaurant setting. My band is going to be there. My singers are going to be there. DJ Mosky from KHLH is going to be there.
Kids in the Spotlight's
going to be there. Roe is going to be there. I mean, it's going to be heaven's party really on earth.
Yes.
I mean,
both roles.
That's what it's about.
Yeah.
And on that note, we have to close out. We're out of time. We're going to close with the party mix.
Oh, wow.
Oh my God. I just thank you both. We're going to keep you
Thank
all
you.
Lifted up.
Thank you. God bless you.
You too, my brother. You too, my studio husband. You too, my studio sister, stream bomber, Sandra. And so, thank you for joining us. I it's almost on the, I call it the dreamer's journey vision. Before we go, I just want to share something that Pastor Frank, who we all know and love, said. A divinely inspired dream is greater than our minds can comprehend, bigger than our abilities to pull it off, and usually is realized in stages.
Yes.
Dream with your eyes wide open. Believe, 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 and get quiet before God and walk in faith, knowing that there's nothing too hard for Him.
Yeah.
And if He called you to it, He'll see that you can do it and get you through it.
Come on now.
All right.
Look at her.
Problems have expiration dates. His promises does not. On that note, Amen. We love you, love you, love you. We'll see you next week. Or hopefully we'll see you this Wednesday from California.
Wednesday.
From the hills. Yes. Woo! Until then, party on! Party on!